Welcome to Codux, a new visual IDE for React. It allows you to build and edit components visually and side by side with your project's codebase. With Codux, you can develop components in isolation or build fully functional apps. Let's get started by creating a new project. This is the welcome screen. It's what you see when you open up Codux. And it's our first time here, so let's create a new project. First, you just have to name it. Pick a place to save, and then choose one of the styling solutions we have here. Once you're done, you click Create, and you can start your new project. But now it's time to really see Codux in action. Let's head back to the project that I was showing you earlier. We're creating a source control hosting solution. It's called GitDux. This is what our application looks like with all the components put together. But with Codux, we can view each one of these components in isolation. These are boards. They're Codux's way of showing how components respond to different configurations, permutations, and states. Every board is a visual representation of a component. As you can see at the bottom, I have the top bar missing image, and top bar no text. These are all the same component, just with different states. How about we dive into the top bar component? We've brought the component to the stage, so let's make some changes. You can use the elements tree to select the HTML element that you want to edit. And for this instance, we're going to choose top bar. Then navigate to the right side of Codux to open up the properties panel. From there, you can use a visual controller to then edit the component's properties at ease. And any changes that we make here will be reflected in the code and vice versa. So let's edit the location, USA. And then if you notice on the stage and in the code drawer, there's a change to our location. You can also use your own IDE. And yeah, any changes that are made there will also be reflected within Codux. So let's add an organization. You'll see within the visual controller that the Codux was also added to the organization, on the stage, and even within the code drawer. All this happening within real time. The same applies when you want to add an element or a component. All you need to do is open up the add panel, search for your component, and then drag and drop it right into the elements tree wherever you need it to be. Then you'll see the changes here in your code, and you can still edit the properties of this component by opening up the properties panel and adding your value. Now that we figured out how to drill into the structure of our component, let's get into styling it. Underneath the properties panel, we'll find the computed styles panel. This is where we'll get a bird's eye view of our component and how it's styled. You can even view the code, and it'll open up the CSS file, and all the changes will be reflected there as well. To edit the background color, we'll need to get to the styles panel. This is where you'll edit the CSS props, and we can see all the different controllers for layouts, text, borders, and corners. But for right now, we'll pay attention to the background color. We can choose any of the variables that we've created, and I think I'll go with this muted gray. You can see the changes are reflected on the stage and in the code. Since we made all these changes, we'll need a repository to store them in. And with Codux, you have the option to use GitHub as your version control. From here, we could take a look at our change files, leave a commit message, submit it, revert our changes, take a look at our commit history, and even change the branch that we're currently in. You could choose a branch to merge from, open a pull request, and even take a look at the amount of commits that you've made, and see if everything is synced and up to date. This can also be done however you want to manage your Git flows. So if you want to use your own IDE or CLI, you can. These are all just simply files on your machine. Once we've completed the design change, we'll notice that it's reflected in all the places that our component is used and all of its states. And there you have it. This is Codux, the visual IDE for React. Download it on our website.